Guys, I know what it looks like. It is an IP game. It is the IP of the Tensura. That time I got reincarnated as a slime. However, honestly, I am a massive fan of this IP, and so I've got to cover this. Hi, welcome to a Slime Isekai Memories video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about the game's launch, I guess, because the developers kind of like suddenly sprung it on us like out of nowhere, because we thought it would be a little bit later, but then I think like a few hours ago, they were like, actually, we're gonna release it tomorrow. But before we go any further, I just wanna introduce like the contents of the video. So I'm just gonna cover things like what I feel about like the publisher as well as the existing systems that were shown during CBT. So no, unfortunately, I did not have the opportunity to participate in the CBT. However, there has been quite a lot of information compiled. And so a lot of people have actually compiled a lot of different information such as like dupes, equipment, upgrades, skills, stuff like that. And in this video, I do want to share these with you to see if you guys are interested, because I know like some of these things are going to be deal breakers for you guys. And so without further ado, let me start off with this guy over here. And so it says an announcement regards to official launch date. I feel like the English is a little bit off there. Anyway, we've already covered this, so I'm just going to cover this quickly. So essentially the pre-download is already available. And so they are aware that it is going to be a surprise, because they did plan it for a November 2021 release, but they actually were ahead of development schedule. And so the official launch is going to be on Thursday, October 28, 2021 UTC time. After this video comes out, it's probably going to come out in like the next 6 hours. And so you can spend the next 6 hours cramming as much knowledge as you can. However, this is just an announcement date. It'd be kind of cringe if I made a 10-minute video on just this letter. And so the next thing I do want to cover is the pre-registration rewards. So this game actually managed to hit 1 million pre-registrations. It says over here we hit our goal of over 500k, but really we hit 1 mil. So if I come down all the way here, you'll see that there are additional magic crystals that we did clear for 1 million pre-registrations. However, the weird thing about this one is that add to beginner boost login bonus. So this kind of means that we won't be getting it like straight up as a lump sum when we log in. And I suspect this is to fight re-rolling, which it's kind of whatever. And so from the pre-registration rewards, what we are going to get for sure, I believe, is 10 summoning tickets. So as you can see, 200k pre-registrations, 5x recruit tickets, and then we also get that down here, 450k. On top of that, we're also going to get a 5-star guaranteed recruit ticket, which is pretty lit as well. However, again, to I believe combat re-rolling, they're going to only release it on the third day login bonus after creating your account. And so what that means is that we are going to have to re-roll, if you guys are insisting on re-rolling, on the 10 recruitment tickets. Otherwise, the pre-registration rewards seem pretty dank. Like, I believe a roll is 30 magic crystals. And so by the time we clear all of the beginner boost login bonuses, we should have quite a hefty amount. All right, so that's enough about the pre-registrations. Next, I want to talk about these guys over here, which are the developer diaries. So essentially, if you come over to the website, so this is the main website, as you can see, 1000K, aka, I guess, 1 million pre-registered users. If I scroll down a little bit to the news, you'll see that there are a whole bunch of developer diaries, and you can probably see more if you click this button more. And so I just wanted to like put your attention onto this, because they actually cover a lot of different game mechanics if I find my way back into it. So as you can see, like, get magic crystals by increasing the population of Tempest, limit break to complete missions. Like, there are a whole bunch of different systems that are covered in the developer diaries. And so if you do want to do like a little bit of pre-reading, I guess, then I would probably start here. And so with that, let's move on to the next topic, which is this guy over here. And so his name is Slime Isekai Memories Dash News. His name is Belial Sensei. It seems he also has a YouTube channel, but essentially he has been publishing a whole lot of different resources as well as like some of the information from the CBT. This is hella useful, especially for like those of us who weren't able to get into the CBT. And so whilst I can't vouch for his YouTube channel or anything, I can say that like after scrolling through this guy's account, there is quite a lot of information here. And so again, if you do want more information, there is like some bite-sized pieces of it in this account. And so with all of that being said, what exactly am I getting at? And that is just to keep your eye on it if you want more information and updates. That's it. And so the reason that I stopped here is because this is the next thing that I wanted to talk about. As you can see, you can only select from 3 regions: North and South America, EU and other, and Asia Pacific. Obviously, considering I'm from Australia, I will be going on to the Asia Pacific server. However, I guess the more critical piece of information is actually on the second page. So as you can see, the region cannot be changed later. So if you're starting on NA or SA, you cannot come over and visit me in Asia Pacific, you know? So when you are creating your account, just keep that in mind. And so what you guys will notice is that there is no JP option. Like, you would think that JP falls under Asia Pacific. I know that there are some of you who are insistent on playing on Japanese servers, and so I believe that that is actually going to be a separate APK. And so for those of you in that situation, you guys are probably just going to have to go over to Koo app or whatever and find it there. Additionally, I remember seeing somewhere, like on an article, probably not on the main website, but like, if you don't actually fall under any of these three, so just having a look at this web page over here, you can see that there are regions that are supported and unsupported. And so as you can see, we've got Australia, we've got Finland, France, and we've probably got the United States, we've got like the South American countries. And so what you are going to quickly notice is that the majority of the world is kind of not supported, right? Like, old mate in Kazakhstan probably wants to play the game, but they are unable to download it from the app store. Now, there's certainly a way that you can get around this, and that is to actually go onto Koo app or TapTap or one of those like other third-party game stores, and then you look for the app on those game stores, TapTap, Koo app, and then just download it from there. Alternatively, you could also go through like the direct APK install route. So that's like going onto APK Pure, looking for the APK, and then downloading it and putting it into your emulator or phone. And so therefore, if any of you are from like any of these countries, I see like a lot of countries that are really into gacha games, like India, we've got Vietnam over here, etc. and so forth, whatever. Like, don't despair, guys, because you will almost certainly be able to play it through one of these methods. As far as I know, there is no VPN lock, and so you guys should be able to just directly access it as long as you have the APK. And then after you get the APK, you're probably just going to go over and select the closest region to you. All right, and so hopefully that covers off the regioning, and of course, this is not officially endorsed advice. If anybody asks, I didn't tell you this, okay? So with that, let's move on. Let's see what we have next. So here are the battle characters. And so I wanted to show you guys this because this is essentially all of your, I believe, 5 and 4 star characters. And so to add to that, I'm pretty sure the characters also go like not only from 5 to 4, but also to like 3 and 2. But it was very recently revealed in one of these dev posts that you can actually take anybody, all characters up to 6 stars. And so how exactly do we do that? Honestly, I can't tell you right now because I have not like seen the data for that. But anyway, these are your battle characters. And so what that means is that the battle characters are going to be in the field doing things to the enemy, if you know what I'm saying. They are the ones that are going to form your main party. And so I don't know if you can use 4 Rimurus, but that would be pretty funny. Anyway, so the reason that I'm making that distinction is because if I flip over to the next page, you're going to see we have a whole bunch of protection characters. And so these protection characters are essentially kind of like your supports, right? So again, these guys do not stand on the front line. They don't stand on the field. I believe they just provide like supportive buffs and stuff like that. All right. And so with all of that, let's move on to this spreadsheet over here. And so as you can see, work in progress reroll guide, I'm pretty sure we don't need a reroll guide for this game. And the reason for that is that, well, if I remember correctly, there should be a button on the title screen. So if you go to the title screen and then you go to like the settings, I'm almost positive that I saw CBT footage with that holding a delete data button. And so what that means is that after you've done your rolls, after you've done your 10 rolls and you're not happy with it, you should theoretically be able to just like tap into the settings and then tap on the delete data, and then away it goes. Now, there are actually quite a fair few ways that they could screw us over on this. And the main method in my mind, because I've seen it so many times before on like World Flipper and all that, is that they're actually going to like put a 24-hour timer or like some sort of timer to stop you from like constantly deleting your game data. And so if that turns out to be the case, I would ask you guys to not only subscribe, but like follow along so that you can see the types of reroll methods that I have in mind. It's probably going to be like the classic trinity. You've got like the salting method, delete the shared prefs, and then you've got like the change device IDs. But again, that is just assuming that they are going to go down that more, I don't want to call it scummier, but like kind of scummier route. Anyway, so just stay tuned for that one, guys. All right, so back to the pre-reg rewards. As you can see, it does total up 10 times recruitment tickets, but all of this is kind of inconsequential since we'll be getting it anyway, but I wanted to really show you this one here. 5-star units drop at a 3-star rate, whilst 5-star supports drop at a 1-star rate. And so what this is screaming out to me is that if we are going to reroll, it's probably better to reroll for the supports because it is dropping at such an abysmal rate. You're freaking 3 times more likely to get a 5-star unit drop than you are to get a support. And so I'm pretty sure that anyone that reads this will be able to come to the same conclusion. Okay, that's really awkward because like I just read the sentence, which is essentially saying what I just said. So moving on, because that was kind of embarrassing. We've got the elemental interactions down here. So obviously water beats fire, fire beats earth, earth beats cubes, and cubes beats the wind. So I feel like something went wrong there. And then on top of that, we've got the classic light versus dark, like countering each other. But otherwise, I just kind of want to introduce you guys to this spreadsheet because it's very, very well put together. It's pretty much like a neat database. I don't know if there are any wikis, but like in case there isn't, this kind of shows you everything that you need. And so just moving on, we've got like different types of skills and what they do. And then on top of that, we've got the traits, and then we've got the protection characters, which is kind of the counterpart to the battle characters again. And then after that, it's just more data. So we've got maps, which is still coming soon, item picks, and then artwork, which is, ooh, I don't know about you guys, but I like what I see. Freaking Gobta, man. Gobta is such a freaking Chad. Anyway, that is the spreadsheet covered. And so as always, I'll be linking all of the resources, everything that we have covered down in the description below. And so moving on from this hunk, we are going to go over to the equipment guide. And okay, so here's where it starts to get a little bit dank. Again, I'm just gonna link this to you guys, and so you guys can kind of see how you feel about all of this. But there is a particular section that I do want to show you guys, which is this one over here. And so during equipment crafting, oh God, here we go. There is certainly an element of RNG. So if I scroll a bit closer, if you guys can see that. And so hopefully you guys can see that this sword has an attack range of between 50 to 90. And so what that means is that when you craft your weapon, your final stat for the attack is gonna sit in between there. And so what that sounds like is that if you're a min-maxer, you're probably gonna have a pretty bad time. But yeah, in the equipment guide, this is what stood out to me. And I know for some people, that is going to be a deal breaker. All right, again, this bad boy is going to be in the description. And so I wanted to cover off one last thing, which is the dupe system. And so if we do manage to pull a dupe, what we are going to get is a tier. And this is very common practice, right? You got your constellations and Genshin Impact. You've got like your unlock or whatever tiers or currencies in the other games. In this game, they are going to be called memory stones. And so what these memory stones are going to do is that they are going to enable your characters to go past level 80. So to get from level 80 to the true max level cap of level 100, you actually need dupes, one memory stone, which is, for example, Xion here, we need another Xion, or you're going to need to consume 5 normal memory stones. And so I guess like the nice thing about this dupe system is that I don't think you gain any extra utility from the dupes. From the CBT footage, it does look like you're just going to be getting like extra stats. However, these stars are probably going to matter at some point. So for example, maybe like a 5-star Xion can't tank as well as a 6-star one, and so it dies, whereas a 6-star one survives on a certain boss. Just kind of stuff like that, right? So at least it's not like, oh, you need dupes to get your defense down from minus 100 defense to minus 200 defense, for example. And so with that rationale, it kind of makes it okay to me. And so as you guys can see, support characters can also go through the same thing. Oh God. Anyway, that just about wraps up everything that I've kind of like been looking to talk about in this video. And so with that, I do want to leave you guys with a secret question, and it's that, well, are you guys going to give this bad boy a shot? Obviously, I've only gone through like a whole bunch of the different systems, and so I would definitely encourage you guys to go have a look at the website, go have a look at some like CBT footage, and then decide if you do want to play like this turn-based game. So let me just show you guys this guy over here. So you got like Milim, and then she's gonna fire a cannon probably. You see you've got your team over here versing a boss. So that's the battle system in a nutshell. However, we've also got like a town building aspect, which is really cool because it's pretty true to like the anime. Anyway, you guys let me know if you are hyped or if you guys are willing to try this game. And so if you guys could drop your thoughts down into the comments below, I would really appreciate it because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a sub, a follow, a comment. And if you would like to support the channel, we do have a membership thing as well as some affiliate links in the description below. But otherwise, as a bouncy slime once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye bye.